Welcome back, lads and ladettes, to episode 91. We're officially like in the 90s. I guess 90 was in the 90s as well, but now we're like we've surpassed the plateau. We're on our way steadily.
I think, creeping. Yeah, once we get to 90, I think 90 defines us as we're in the 90s. Like when it you does, turn 20, like you're in your 20s.
Yeah, fair. But I don't know. We're making our way. 91 is like, there's no arguing. It's like if you're, if you're like 19, oh God, no. I don't know where I'm going with this. Dude, okay. You know what? Just for everybody who's laughing at me right now, I haven't left my house in 3 days. I've been staring at a screen, working on the new Lads and Launchers website, which will be released shortly. So my eyes are all bloodshot. I'm groggy. I don't know what I'm saying. So we'll see if we can make it through this one. But big things coming, man.
Yeah. You know what also I think throws people off is like the Monday holiday. Yeah. I feel like a Monday holiday is weird because then your whole week is out of whack after that. Like you go a Monday holiday. Now Tuesday is your Monday and you don't have a legitimate hump day. Like you think about when you get to on a regular work week, 5 day week, you get to Wednesday, you finish your day Wednesday and you're like, there we go. We're more than halfway through this thing. 2 days left. We're almost to the weekend. But like once you have a holiday Monday after that, I personally just like lose track of time. I'm like, what day is it today? Because this is like the third day of the week, but it's Thursday. What's happening?
I know. I swear I just started my week and then I'm getting ready to leave my cottage tomorrow for the weekend.
Yeah.
And it's like, what the hell? Like there's no rhythm. There's no rhythm in it. But I'm all for the 4 day work week.
I'm yes. a
firm,
oh, 100%.
Firm advocate of the 4 day.
But I like week. I like the Friday off. That's my feeling. I like that because part of it too is like, if you go to Friday off, you can stretch that week into a Thursday, Friday, Saturday situation. And then you feel good. Like Sunday, you're back. Sunday is normal. You've just had an extended rest. And then before you go into a Monday, but if you have a Monday off, you probably work Friday and then you go like Friday night, you might do something. And then like Saturday, Sunday, and doing something on Sunday is always kind of weird because it's like, it's a Sunday, like it's supposed to be getting ready for the start of the week, but no, you're not now. So then even that just throws it all off.
I got to disagree with you here, man. I think I'd rather have the Monday off.
Really?
Because I'd rather be able to rest during like when I'm supposed to be working. Like if I can just like have a go hard, let's not even go hard, but let's say I have like a cottage weekend or whatever, like Sunday, I get to enjoy the full weekend. And then Monday is just that, I guess it's the same thing as Friday, but I feel like Mondays generally suck more than Fridays do. Friday is like usually a slower paced day. Everyone's kind of like checked out at work, not much to do. So if you don't work there, you're kind of missing out on a lofty work day. Whereas Mondays are always slammed, it seems like. So if I have to miss out on a Monday and then rest on just like a shitty day in general, I think I'd rather do that. I think I'd rather rest all of Monday to regroup for Tuesday than rest all of Friday and then regroup Sunday right before the worst day ever.
Okay. Here's my counter to this though. When you have a Friday off, I think for me, at least I've noticed like Thursday turns into the casual Friday of like the chill Friday.
That is a good point.
So now you've got like Monday push, Tuesday push. Wednesday is like your glorified hump day in terms of like, we already surpassed our hump day. Cause like Tuesday night was hump day and now we're like day three. But once I get through this, I got 1 day left to the weekend. Thursday turns into chill. Thursday night, you can do whatever you want. Right. Thursday is Friday Junior. You can do whatever you want, which is so nice. And then here's the other thing, especially come like September, October, November, and then you push through to like, I guess really it ends in like February, but then you still get a little bit of leftovers in like March, April kind of situation is you can go out on Thursday night. Let's like bring this into going out. If you're going to go out, so you can go out on Thursday night, you can hang out and chill, like, and do whatever on Friday. And I feel like more people are around on the Friday and down to do stuff on the Friday. Then you go into like Saturday, you can do stuff. Sunday, you wake up, you can just chill out. You know what's on TV, Magee, on Sundays? Formula One, golf, if you get it at the right time, you can kick in baseball, football, hockey, basketball.
Yeah.
You can sit on the couch and flip between like 7 or 8 different like sporting events, not even just games, sporting events, sports in general going on. You can just flip back and forth between them.
You got to get like the multiple monitors set up, like just like, give yourself whiplash by the end of the day.
Cause then when you look at that though, like the other thing to it is just like, if you look at that, like Sunday, if you have Monday off, like you're going to push through Sunday. Maybe you don't get the full effect of all the sports on Sunday. And now Monday you're just hanging out and you're like, it's Monday. Like nothing's really going on today because it's a Monday. Like a lot of times they will push sports to Monday, but like they're not really pushing football to midday on Monday or like golf to Monday or anything like that. So then you're kind of just, it's not really the same.
I think I agree with you because when you were like kind of making your counter argument there, it kind of dawned on me that I think people may get a little bit more energetic with an earlier time off. Whereas like Sunday is still Sunday in people's minds and they'll kind of slow it down Sunday and even quieter Monday. So they'll be like super refreshed, ready to go Tuesday. Whereas an early break from work, let's say Friday off, everyone just like off to the races. So that, and they go hard right through Sunday afternoon sometimes when they're driving home from their cottage. So Monday they'll be a little bit more burnt out. I like that. I got another question for you, Zach.
Okay. Yeah.
Is it just me or are Thursday, October, and the color purple the same thing?
I agree with like the October. I don't know about the purple. I think the purple was just like thrown in the mix there. And I don't know if I can get on board with purple, but I agree with you of like Thursday and October. Like I've seen those before where people are like, this day is like, they like associate the day or like a number. They'll be like, this number is like this day, this month. And you're like, makes sense.
The number seven is Thursday.
Or day. And it just is like, you're right. Like that makes sense. Like I actually is like when you
doesn't
say
mean
it,
anything. It's actually just nonsense. Nothing.
Yeah. I could have said any number any day of the week and you'd probably be like,
and there's someone, I can see it.
Makes sense. Yeah.
There's like someone out there is going to agree with you, whatever you say.
Yeah.
You know what? Just in the spirit of things, actually, maybe we'll do this after our player battle, but I just want to hear your list of shittiest months.
Shittiest months. Okay. Well, love July and August. Let's, I'm going to reverse.
Yeah. Reverse engineer this
because,
this
like, yeah. Okay. So, love July and August for sure. Fan of June, definitely.
Yeah.
December, I get on board with December. You know what? I actually kind of like the weather in September because, like, September is you can still wear shorts, but you can wear like shorts and a long sleeve or shorts and a hoodie or reverse and you go pants and a t-shirt. Like, and it's comfortable. It's still sunny. It's never really too cold. It's not raining. No snow, like, no chance of snow. I enjoy October because you can work yourself into Halloween. Halloween's always fun, parties, dressing up, going out, like being at school for Halloween in October was a lot of fun. And again, like still not miserable, like beginning of October, primo weather. Like it's cool. It's, not freezing. You can still go outside and enjoy like patios and stuff. But then once you get to the end of October, it's like, November, definitely shitty month. November is a shitty month.
Because like November is right in the smack dab of like exams and stuff too.
Yeah, exams.
But it's just the weather shit.
But like even nothing is happening. Like what goes on in November? Thanksgiving is in October.
Yeah.
Then you just basically are just like existing in November. The weather sucks. Here.
It's horrible. Like, it's not quite snowing, it's still frigid. Yeah.
And it's just gray and cold and just wet and just nasty.
Yeah. All of I think November. There's one month that I think is worse than November, but I'm gonna let you get your train of thought.
So I like December because like basically I think we talked about it on here. Like December 1, it's like we're getting ready for Christmas, and December is like all of December is Christmas. That's just like, that's what it is. It's like 1 month of Christmas and just like people being in a good mood and like chocolates and candy and Michael Bublé. And like, it's the most wonderful time of the year.
100%.
All pun intended. I can't say March because it's my sister's. My sisters were born in March. So
yeah,
I'm going to rock with March. St. Paddy's Day, you know what? And actually March too, weather starts changing. You're moving towards nicer weather in March. You get those really nice days. Like think about the outdoor parties in March that you get to go do. So it's like, okay, we're working towards it. Still a little bit of snow on the ground, but like, it's not terrible. It's pretty good. Man, you know, what's actually kind of a shitty month. April.
Really?
Yeah, because I feel like maybe I'm wrong, but like I feel like April for me has always been associated with like exams, and then part of April too is like you don't really expect much from March because once it starts turning sunny and like the snow is melting, I feel like you get into a better mood. You're like, oh, like we're moving in the right direction here. Like summer's coming, the hot weather's coming, and like, then sweet. You're like, yeah, you're like, this is a bonus. And then like, if it gets cold again in March, you're like, ah, it's still March. Like, what do we expect here? And then like April comes and it's just like snows one day and you're like,
everything is ruined.
Fuck this. Like,
yeah, and then your exam, it's like March is such a, I like March, but March is like such a tease for things to come. And it's like, you almost get thrown in reverse when April comes.
Fully. It actually just like goes backwards when April comes. Yeah, I don't know. What are you going to say? You're not a fan of February, aren't you? Like, I feel like that's the one. I
despise February.
What's wrong with February?
My least favorite month. What's not wrong with February? February is my least favorite month for many reasons. One, like it's kind of like January I like because it's my birthday month. The whole like New Year's thing, always a good time.
Yeah.
And it's like the first little bit of it is like still in winter break and you're kind of just chilling.
I feel like January is just like generally like kind of exciting too. It's like it's a new year. Like you're like,
I think it's like most laid back, like non-holiday month.
Fair. Okay.
But I think that I really hate February. One, the weather's shit. Like everything's kind of starting to warm up again. And it's the overcast thing like November. It's just that same overcast gray nonsense. Instead of just dry ground, you have all that brown slushy shit just still like kicking around the streets. You walk, your shoes get all ruined, like you don't know what to wear because it's like, is it like it's not quite like spring yet? But just depressing as hell. It's short, which I guess is the only good thing about it, but I was doing some reading and apparently February has the highest suicide rates of any month.
Oh wow. I mean, like I don't know if I'm overly surprised. I feel like you throw in like Valentine's Day in there too. That's and like not to make light of it. Yeah, it's just like it's stressful and like it's just like people are going through a lot of stuff and then the weather sucks and it's just like
I feel like this it's is more not stressful ideal. For I feel like Valentine's Day is more stressful for women.
You think so?
Like, okay, let me phrase it this way. I think that like the least stressed person on Valentine's Day is a woman in a relationship. She's chilling.
Okay.
The second least stressed person on Valentine's Day is a single man because he doesn't give a fuck.
Okay. Yeah.
The third least stressed person is the guy in the relationship because although he's got to like think of something and do something nice, it's still like, fun.
But he's also technically the second most stressed.
No, I think that. Second most stressed.
Yes.
The most stressed person on Valentine's Day has to be the single woman who's just seeing all this shit on her timeline or like her wall or whatever the hell. I feel like that's because they always like, I feel like a lot of women have a Galentine's Day and stuff. Like, I don't know. Like, guys don't do that. It's like, what the hell? So, is that like a compensation?
We should have a Latentine's Day.
Yeah, we need a Latentine's Day event. 100%. Yeah, let's do it.
Latentine's. I'm going to come to your house and like bring you flowers and chocolate, Magee, for Latentine's.
We should have an event or something. Like, we already got so many ideas in the works. Why not like have like a Latentine's Day like speed dating event or some shit? Or like get some like I don't know, man. We should do something. A Latentine's Day party. We'll figure
I
it
think we
out.
got to roll out Lollapalooza first.
Yeah,
That's
we do.
the
We do.
biggest
I think
venture. We
just,
can't put
I'm
out.
just, yeah, I'm looking forward to making February a less shitty month. That's what,
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. I respect that.
yeah.
I respect that. Okay, well, at this point, we've gone on long enough into this episode without doing our player battles. I think we got two good competitors in this one.
Oh, yeah.
And still sticking with the spirit of the Olympics. We got to go with judo here because judo, I kind of dissed on judo last episode, just basically saying how easy it is. And like, I think though, Magee, like if you, did you read this, the judo description that I put in here?
I
like
did,
it,
yeah.
It seems very, very much exactly as I described it in the last episode. So judo competitors out there, I'm sorry, but like, I'm also not like when I read this description and I like break this down, Magee and I break this down. It's as I described it, really. It is very simple. It's not as technical in many ways as the other martial arts. And what is that the best way to describe it, me? Just the other martial arts? Or what
yeah,
did we
I'd
say last time?
I'd say so. It's a
like
martial,
combat.
Yeah. Combat
so,
sports.
Because I knocked judo last time and it's a 1v1 competition, I figured it was best if we put these guys in a judo competition this week, a judo matchup. And I think that to put two professional athletes in the judo competition could create some interesting conversation here. So judo, basically, let me break it down for you for those who are not fully aware of judo, where it came from and what the rules are. Judo means the gentle way. But it is a full-on combat sport in which a false move or the slightest loss of concentration can result in defeat. By the way, this is all from the Olympic website. Okay, so this is a legitimate reference here.
Yeah.
Judo originated in Japan in the late 19th century as an activity embracing physical, mental, educational, and moral aspects. The objective of judo is to throw or take down an opponent to the ground, subdue them with a pinning hold, or force them to submit with a joint lock or a choke. Athletes, known as judoka, wearing white or blue judogi, judo uniforms, face each other on a 10 meter by 10 meter mat and deploy any of the 100 techniques available. These are divided into 68 nagawaza, throwing techniques, and 32 katamawaza, grappling techniques.
Love that accent.
Thank you. The highest score a judoka can earn is ippon. It is the ultimate way to claim victory in the match, and it is the highest score in judo. After ippon is scored, the match is over. A judgment of ippon for a throwing technique puts the opponent on their back with strength, speed, and control. If a throw or other technique is successfully executed, but all the requirements for ippon are not met, waza-ari, a half point, is awarded. Two waza-aris in one match is the equivalent of ippon. If scores are tied, the bout goes into golden score or overtime. In golden score or overtime, the first contestant to achieve a further score wins. So okay. It kind of seems here like put the person on their back, waza-ari, game. That's it. You get the 1 point, done. If you choke somebody out, waza-ari, game, done. Like yeah. If you don't fully put the person on their back and like have them submit in that way or like whatever it is, and the point is awarded, you get a half point, and all you need is 2 points and you win.
Yeah, I feel like it's more tactical. Well, you just gotta be like, it's definitely a slower martial art, but I think you really gotta pick and choose your spots, otherwise like you're screwed. One slip up and it's, you're done. So maybe that's what makes it intense, and that's what makes judo like,
well, I mean, that was the first sentence here. It is a full-on combat sport in which a false move or the slightest loss of concentration can result in defeat.
So that's. I still think it sounds exactly like what my brother and I would do, like at home. You know what I mean?
Like, oh yeah, I agree. That's what I'm saying. Is like, I'm going to college this weekend with some of our friends, and like, by Sunday, I wouldn't be surprised if me and Kent have competed in judo at some point. Like,
I feel like everybody in the world has participated in judo at one point without knowing it's judo.
I honestly may have to get someone to videotape it, and Kent and I will throw down in judo and we'll put it on the Lads and Launchers story.
Yeah, do it, man. Do
and
it, do
we'll
it.
Just like grapple in the front lawn, just like
was
going
Ari.
at it. We'll see what happened.
You're
And then
come out
yeah,
with all the terminology because he's like, what the hell? Like, I'm Japanese, I don't even know this.
Yeah, he's like, was Ari, what is that? So yeah, I'm gonna submit this guy, I'm gonna choke him out. Basically, that's the whole plan. It's gonna be on the Lads and Lawn Chairs story, so make sure you go look at it. It'll have been up by the time this episode is out. But anyways, Let's get into our players here. So two great number 91s, both professional hockey players. Let's do it. Our first competitor in the judo battle. He was drafted first overall in the 2009 NHL entry draft by the New York Islanders. He's going into his 13th season in the NHL, having played 9 seasons for the Islanders before moving on and just completing his 3rd season for the Toronto Maple Leafs. In 870 career games played, he's totaled 364 goals, 455 assists, and 819 points for a .94 points per game average. A 2-time World Junior Gold Medalist, a World Cup Gold Medalist, and an Olympic Gold Medalist. A 6'1", 207-pound center from Mississauga, Ontario, and the captain of the Toronto Maple Leafs, John Tavares. If before I go into the second player here, if anybody listening has never noticed, after every time that I finish the first player, Magee does this. Magee, go ahead. That is not an imported effect. It's just Magee doing the quiet background noise of the crowd going nuts. So, yeah. Our second competitor in the judo competition. He was drafted first overall in the 2008 NHL entry draft by the Tampa Bay Lightning. He's heading into his 14th season in the NHL, having played his entire career with the Tampa Bay Lightning. In 841 games played, he's put together 439 goals and 427 assists for 866 points and a 1.03 points per game average. A World Junior Gold Medalist, a World Cup Gold Medalist, a World Championship Silver Medalist, a 2-time recipient of the Maurice Richard Trophy, and a 2-time Stanley Cup Champion. A 6'1", 194-pound center from Markham, Ontario, and the captain of the Tampa Bay Lightning, Steven Stamkos.
This is a no-brainer in my eyes.
Okay.
First, like, the one thing I gotta say before I get into my my like kind of argument here is, do you think if you were like let's say Tavares,
yeah,
he's at 0.94 points per game. Do you think and Stamkos is like just above a point a game?
Yeah, 1.03.
Yeah, do you think at this point in their careers, they're taking a look at their own stats and being like, oh my God, like I need to finish with a point a game on my career? Do you think that's something they take into consideration, or do they just like, ah, whatever, like it is what it is?
You know what? Like, I think Stamkos probably is like, let's keep that point per game. I feel like Tavares, like, publicly at least displays the kind of like nonchalantness of like, like I don't care about that, like I just want the team to win. And the other thing to add to it is like 0.94, he's farther away from point per game than Stamkos is being point per game, like 0.1, 0.03. So Stammer probably in the back of his mind is like 0.03, like yeah, it's right there, I gotta hold on to that,
not
thing.
A lot of leeway, not a lot no, of wiggle room there.
I gotta hold on to that thing.
But well, that kind of thing you brought up about Stamkos is more like, I guess, competitiveness, or competitive edge, the fact that he wants to kind of be selfish in that way. And if, allegedly, we don't know, maybe, mm-hmm, maybe he's not. But I think, one, he's from Markham, Ontario.
Mm-hmm.
Just a winner. And I don't know why, but I, even though Tavares is heavier than Stamkos, I think Stamkos is stronger than Tavares.
Yo, the only problem I have with going with Stamkos in judo specifically...
Oh, shit, his knees, man.
His knees. No. This guy has bad knees, bro.
That's true.
I don't
true.
Know if we
that's
can trust
true.
That. So,
yeah, you're right, man. You're right. I forgot about his knees.
Because I was like, this guy's a winner. Like, he's got over a point per game, blah, blah, blah. Like, obviously, love Tavares, captain of the Maple Leafs. Go Leafs, go. But I was like... Stammer is probably a Stammer's competition. Then all of a sudden it clicked that I was like,
dude, this guy's got a
this guy's
weak
bum
base.
Knees.
Yeah. but this guy, Tavares, on the other hand, is a very solid base.
Yes.
So yeah, I think Tavares takes this one. I hate to go against my guy from Markham, but dude, it's
yeah,
sad. Tavares wins this one easily.
Yeah, easily. Congrats to Stammer. Like, plays with friend of the show, someone who came on, Anthony Cirelli, two-time Stanley Cup champion. Congratulations to him for that. But unfortunately, you didn't win the ultimate prize of being the episode 91 judo challenge champion. So I think we're going to have to give this one to Tavares.
And it sucks though, because there's nothing to do with his judo ability or like anything else.
No, no. He could be the world's greatest judo competitor, but
his knees, his weak knees. Damn. Yeah. All right. Well, yeah.
Knees weak, arm spaghetti.
I hate that Tavares won that though. Especially against
Stan. I don't think I like it either. I'm kind of mad I brought up the point. It was like, it just clicked in my head. I was like, bum knees. And like, as soon as I was saying, but you knew exactly where I was going. Like the face you made, you looked at me and you were like, oh no.
Yeah. Just like, very shocked, man.
Yeah.
This is going to be an incredibly hot take, incredibly scorching take.
Just give it. Yeah.
I'm not a fan of John Tavares. Like, really? I'm not a huge John Tavares fan. I think he's like kind of overrated. I think he's definitely a superstar, but I think he's an overrated superstar. And just something, even though he's not on the Islanders, I'm not an Islanders fan. Something about like leaving his like OG team to sign with like a kind of a super team kind of just rubs me the wrong way as a Leaf, and I'm a Leafs fan too.
Mm-hmm.
So like, it's a hot take. I'm not the biggest John Tavares fan.
I like him. I just don't think he should have been the captain in Toronto.
I agree with that.
Yeah,
I agree with him coming over just to be like another like a star on the team and put up points. Yeah, great. But I don't know, man. I don't think you can make someone who abandons ship a leader like that quickly.
You want to just like think so. Kind of interesting is Stamkos and Tavares were drafted 1 year apart, both first overall, obviously. But like, I obviously knew this, but I didn't like put it together until I read this number. Tavares is 4 years younger than Sidney Crosby.
That makes sense. I think that checks out.
Like, it makes sense. And it's not that I didn't know that. It was just like, if you were to stand Tavares and Crosby side by side, would you ever like look at them and be like, yeah, that guy's like 4 years younger? Like, I know it's Sid the kid, and he like looks young, but it's also just like, I don't know.
I think the way they skate, though,
is like...
Tavares plays like an old man, for sure.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, is like, even just the way they play, I'm like, Tavares is an old man. Then I'm like, wait a minute. No, he's not. Like, I don't know.
Like 30 on the dot? 31?
I'm just going to check right now. So, Kroos, obviously, born in 87.
Yeah, he's 30 years old.
My bad. Yeah, but Crosby turns 34 this year.
Yeah. Wow.
Like, is that not?
It is weird. It is pretty weird.
I guess though. Tavares turns 31 in September, so Crosby's only 3 years older technically.
Yeah, it's pretty wild to me how like I saw this like tweet, not this tweet, or it was like maybe an Instagram post, one of those weird like I get a lot of basketball shit on my Instagram feed, so I always see random stats and stuff. And I saw this crazy stat. It was this rookie on the, I think, at the Lakers. I could be wrong, so don't crucify me.
Okay.
But it was like Chris Duarte. I don't know. He's a rookie for the Lakers, I think, going into his first season.
Okay.
At 24 years old, which is like pretty fair to come into the league in your first year as a 24-year-old, because like not
on the Pacers, Chris Duarte on the Pacers.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. On the Pacers. So he's coming in his first year at 24 years old, which again, pretty reasonable age to become a pro.
Yeah.
And he's the same age as Devin Booker, who's in his seventh season, or will be going into his seventh season.
Yeah. Yeah. You're right. You're right. Because he would have started out of college at like 18 or 18, whatever.
Almost a decade in the league.
Yeah.
And this guy's coming in for the first time. And like, mind you, everyone's got their own path. Like, there's no judgment there. It's just,
yeah,
like
he played college ball and like, yeah. Have you ever seen those like, those ones where it's like a context of like, this thing in the world has been around for longer than this, or like this thing was alive closer to the time of this happening
Oh
than this
yeah,
was.
man. Yeah.
Those, some of those are trippy. I'm not doing it justice in terms of like how I'm explaining it, but like, and I don't even want to give an example because as soon as I say it, someone's gonna be like, that's wrong, you're an idiot. But it's like, it's just stuff. I will just throw out an
I
example.
got I
Just,
got okay, I got two
okay, no,
examples
go
as
ahead
well.
because maybe you got going this
Okay.
right.
My examples are we are closer in the grand in the general timeline of everything that's ever happened. We are closer to a living T-Rex than a living T-Rex was to a living Stegosaurus.
Those are the exact ones that I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Those are the ones I'm talking about. When you
Which is
see that
crazy.
stuff, it's like, whoa, wow,
Yeah.
that's it, wild. Like, it's just mind blowing
I
for a
know.
quick second of
And
like,
then another one is like at this current point in time, as like a civilization, we are closer to the Roman Empire than the Roman Empires were to the Egyptians.
yeah, those are exactly, those are the, like, Miggy, these are the exact ones that I'm thinking of. It's just like,
Yeah.
that stuff is so wild to see.
Boy,
Even
do I
just
have a
like,
YouTube channel for you?
okay,
Okay, well,
good.
obviously, while we're on the subject of YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube channel. That's right,
Yeah.
we're on YouTube. At Lads and Lawn Chairs, check out our channel, watch some of our videos. It'll definitely add a little spice, add a little another element, another layer to our show.
Yeah, watch
So if you
Miggy's
haven't
face when
already, yeah.
I about to butt in and tell him that Steven Stamkos has bum knees and watch his
Yeah.
reaction.
Yeah. But if you're not watching our YouTube channel, Philly, this is specifically for you. You got to watch this channel called Kurzgesagt. Kurzgesagt. I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's in a nutshell. You search in a nutshell on YouTube, and
Oh.
then it's like both. It's like Kurzgesagt in a nutshell.
Okay.
And it's a little like icon, it's like a globe, and it's got like a bunch of videos about like kind of conspiracy, not conspiracy stuff, well, kind of conspiracies and like what would happen if like everybody on planet Earth was in one like, city or one continent, or like are there aliens? Like it talks about the entire history of everything that's ever happened. It talks about like just how minuscule we are in the grand scheme of things and like the entire universe.
Okay.
And it goes into like great details, really well researched and really well done. And it's got like cool little animations to go along with it. Like the animations are so cool. And they're just like enjoyable to watch. Not only are they informative, they're just entertaining as hell. And they're great. They're just great. On a nice
And they're
slow,
great.
slow Sunday, or not even on a just like cozy Friday night.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'm
you're
down. I'll take a
you
gander
yeah,
through
it's
and we'll look at this.
they're
I think that
dope,
would
they're
be pretty
dope.
interesting. Yo, Miggy, honestly, I don't know why, but I just got the urge to do a Mad Lib.
Really? Yeah, let's
We
do
haven't
it.
done Mad Libs in a while, and
No,
we've done
no.
these segments, and Mad Libs is kind of one that we like was pretty fun to do with all the boys.
Yeah.
But I just want to do rip through a short one here. I feel like
Hold
we can get into. I feel like
I
we
was
can
gonna
get
say,
into like
okay,
a
go ahead.
good. No, go ahead. No, you go ahead.
I would just say I honestly think it's been so long. I don't even remember what an adjective or what a
Yeah, this
pronoun
is
or
like part of
anything.
the fun of it, though. I feel like we could like
Learning it
figure
all
this out.
again.
Yeah, like let's relearn this,
Basic like
and get back to like learning the
English.
English
All right,
language and see if we can figure this out. So like for
let's
the
do
sake of the viewers, we'll do it quickly and we'll do a shorter one. I'm not going to say the name of this reading
it.
until we actually read it out. But let's work through these together. We'll try and pick the best ones. The way we used to do it was I would say what it was, and the first person to shout out the one was what I would type in for the
Yeah,
story. But
let's just alternate back and forth. I think that might go smoother.
let's brainstorm. Like we'll pick ones
Okay,
together because like
yeah.
I feel like there's going to be ones where I'm like I don't know what that is. So,
Okay.
all right. First one, verb past tense. So verb past
Hopefully, no
tense,
one
I
can hear
think,
my.
is like, isn't
Like
verb like an
brought.
action?
Yeah, like had. Forgot, forgot. Anticipated.
Anticipated?
Apologized.
Apologized. That's the one. apologize. A time.
Like a year or like a time on a clock?
I think just time on a clock. Maybe we could just make it extremely specific, like a date, a time, a year.
Let's talk whatever. About, let's say, because you were talking about dinosaurs here. Let's talk about the Jurassic era.
Okay. Do you got like a date on that or just Jurassic era?
What's the year? I guess the years didn't exist. Like, no one was there to invent years yet.
Okay.
Okay. It's 201.3 million years ago.
Oh, good. Okay. 201.3 million years ago. I'm writing that whole thing in there.
Yeah.
Adjective. Descriptive. Is that a descriptive word? Is that what an adjective is?
I believe so.
Adjectives.
You could say the vigorous. You got one for me? Acidic.
Dignified.
Yeah, let's do it.
Dignified, this one?
Yeah.
Okay. Noun. Noun is a person, place, or thing, right? John Tavares. A proper noun. Oh, what is that? A proper noun? Come on.
Ladsandlaunchers.com. Does that count? Isn't a proper noun like... Wait, hold on. What's a proper noun? Yeah, like proper nouns would be... That would make sense. Let's do ladsandlaunchers.com.
Okay. An adverb. Dude, I really got to brush up on my English.
Same, man. Same. Hopefully, you don't hear the clickety clack of my keyboard in the background.
Abruptly.
Ooh, yeah.
A number.
91.
Nice. Adjective. Brilliant.
Oh, I like that.
Another adjective.
I got this one.
Okay.
Oh man, so many to choose from. Creepy.
Ooh, okay. Creepy. And a verb, a present verb ending in ing.
Licking.
Yes, that's the one. Okay. Ready?
Are we? Is this
the one? I don't know.
We'll see. Okay.
I'm excited. The anticipation is killing me.
This is called Airport Taxi Ride. We apologized at the airport 201.3 million years ago, both exhausted and dignified. We hailed a taxi and told the driver to take us to the nearest John Tavares. From there, we decided we could find something to eat and get some rest to prepare for the next day. The driver, who told us his name was ladsandlawnchairs.com, pulled out of the airport parking lot abruptly. 91 minutes later, we still had not arrived at any hotel. It was so brilliant outside, and we were both so creepy, we did not pay attention to where he was taking us. Before we knew it, we were riding down a long dirt road. Licking, we asked the driver, "Where are we?" That's
it. This poor taxi driver. We're just a couple creepy guys in the back seat.
Some of them ended up working really well. Like,
pulled out of the parking lot abruptly. That was a good
yeah. That
the
was
the one
good.
That I was pissed off about was like, if I wish John Tavares were a taxi driver.
Yeah. Like, it just didn't work out.
It just flipped the wrong ones because I'm pretty sure the ladsandlaunchers.com would have worked for John Tavares too.
Yeah. Driver to take us to the nearest ladsandlaunchers.com. And then from there, we decided we could find something to eat and get some rest to prepare for the next day. The driver who told us his name was John Tavares. Yeah like it would have worked perfect if we did that.
It would have worked so well.
Yeah, I don't know. The Mad Libs, I think, are pretty fun. I kind of like that, doing that there, Magee. I think we'll touch up on on our English language and the rules of the English language. We'll get better at that. Maybe we'll figure out a way to do this like a little faster as we go along, because I think that the Mad Libs are fun.
They are fun. We're going to be English geniuses by the time this is done, though, right?
Yeah, we're just going to be snapping them off.
We are so rusty.
You know what I'm going to have to do, Magee? You might have to do it as well, is just like print off lists of these things and just like post them on your walls. Yes. Yeah, so you can see them.
That's good. I like that. I like that idea. Yeah. That's good.
Okay, so as Magee said before we did this, if you aren't watching us on YouTube yet and so you watching YouTube is something you do, make sure you go check out our channel, because if you really, really want to see a hamster wheel turn, you're gonna watch the Mad Lib section and watch Magee and I try to figure out what adverbs and proper nouns are as we tried to fill out this airport taxi ride story. That was an absolute adventure right there,
dude. That was just like kind of, that was the most like research I've done. I don't know, actually it's a lie, but it was a lot of research for me.
Yeah,
it's a lot of research.
But honestly, I think the Mad Libs were good. The Mad Libs are back, Magee. You know what else is back? Football yeah. is so back, and you know what that means? It means the NBA is on its way back, the NHL is on its way back. I like the MLB is winding down, getting ready for playoffs here. It is a good time for pro sports. We get into really nice weather to end out August. Football is on all the time. You got NFL football, college football, whatever you could ask for there. Baseball is on all the time. Golf tournaments kicking up, like it is just prime. But football being back means some more gambling. And right now I go to check on it because the Hall of Fame game is on. And I saw a whole bunch of things saying to take the over. So if you don't know what betting the over is, it's like there's an overall prediction of total points scored in the game, and you just bet on that. You don't even bet like on a team to win. And everyone was saying to bet the over in the Hall of Fame game that I was seeing on Twitter. There's 2 minutes left in the third quarter right now, and there's 12 points scored in the game. I'm pretty sure the total of the over was set at like 40 something points.
Oh my God.
Yeah. So
did you take the over?
I did not bet that. No, okay. I bet on the Cowboys to win, and they're losing 9-3 with 2 minutes left in the third quarter. So
lockdown defense.
Yeah. And you know what that actually really means? Because it's an exhibition game. It's like preseason, is it's just garbage football. But football is so back. I'm pumped about that. Mad Libs is back. Got to be excited about that. And you know what else I think we should bring back this week? A little bit of a this or that. All right, so I only got a few this or that's for us this week. I think we're kind of getting to the point of going into like a little bit shorter episodes here. I think it's kind of nice. It's not extended out. We're not trying to jam too much into each episode, but let's get into these ones. We got three here. Some of them are kind of easy, and then we got one that is going to be kind of philosophical, I think. So the first one here, give up coffee or alcohol?
Well, there's two paths you can go down here. I think that, don't get me wrong, I enjoy coffee. I enjoy alcohol as well. But I don't think I could sit here and really pretend that I'm a saint. Nor do I want to sit here and pretend that like, oh, I just can't live without my cup of coffee in the morning. Like those people need to like just grow up. When there's a will, there's a way. I'd rather give up coffee. I'd rather give up. I can easily go without coffee. I think it would just be like, it would be easy to give up alcohol too, I think, but not at this point in my life.
It would be easy to give up alcohol, but not now. No, I don't know. I agree. I think I'd have to give up coffee too, but it's hard because like, you know, I drink 2 cups of coffee every day. I have a coffee when I leave here at 6 a.m. Mm-hmm. and I have a coffee sometime around 9:30, 9:45. But like, and I don't need alcohol to have fun. I'm not not. And I don't drink like a lot, but like, it's nice to be able to have the option.
Just
to whereas like,
or whatever.
Yeah, and just to like, go out and hang out and go to the bars and stuff. That's an enjoyable experience. I personally am not the type of person to go to like a coffee house and like sit down to enjoy like coffee with people.
No, it'll be a quick like drive through rep. And at the bar too, I think it's like there's one thing if it's house parties or whatever, you're not drinking. That's like, that's cool.
Yeah.
But I feel like just not drinking at a bar, like from my experience, it's like the worst thing ever. Like I can deal with drunk friends, but dealing with drunk strangers when you're like the only sober guy, it's kind of a nightmare.
Yeah. You're right. You're right. Because like hanging out with your friends and being sober and like driving people home, or just if you have to just drive yourself home, whatever, it's like, whatever. Like I'm here having a good time with my friends. But like, if you get into a scenario where it's just like annoying drunk people, or not even just annoying, but like just people you don't know, and they're like hammered and trying to talk to you, and you're like,
yo, stop.
yeah, I could see that being a scenario where like, yeah, no, I don't know.
And another reason, which is what I'm going to go with as my main reason, my number one reason I chose to give up coffee, is alcohol is just so much more diverse. Like that includes wine. It includes like having a glass of scotch with your dad. It includes like my dad, if we have like a, not your dad, Philly. yeah. Like I just think it's so much more diverse. You can do a whole lot more with it.
Yeah. And here's the other thing. Okay. You can have coffee at night.
Yeah.
But like, you got to have like for the most part, you got to have a decaf unless you're kind of just like an absolute sicko of a person. But like, to go and have, you could have alcohol at like any time of the day in any form of things. Like you could even put alcohol in your coffee. You can have mimosas, you can have champagne, you can have beers, you can have like cocktails, Caesars. There's so many ways to have it. And you could have it at any time of the day, like in any kind of setting. Whereas coffee is like kind of restricted to a certain time of the day. You can push pace and like have one later in the day if you really need a kick. But like, I don't know. I'm just going to go with give up coffee here.
Yeah. All right. So the next one we got here is, would you rather be stuck indoors for the rest of your life or stuck outdoors? Well, man, it certainly feels like I've been stuck indoors for my whole life these past few days. Man, I honestly, like, oh, my parents are going to kill me. I haven't watered the flowers or anything or cut the grass. It's probably looking terrible. I haven't checked. I'll have to do that after this episode's done. I would rather spend the rest 10, of my 15. Life. Oh, God.
McGee's going to be mowing the lawn at 10:15.
Dude, I'm in limbo right now. I don't know what's going on. I'd rather be stuck outdoors, though. I think I got pretty good survival skills. I can make a shelter, cook food over a fire. I know how to start a fire. Yeah, like just cottaging. I used to be in Boy Scouts when I was growing up, and a thing called beavers. I did that.
Really? Yeah. What is that like? Can you just tell me what that experience is like? Because I never was a part of it. I only heard.
Yeah, I don't know. It was okay. I was really young. It was more so like something I did like before I even like played hockey. Really, my dad kind of just.
Oh,
like,
okay.
I don't know what my dad was like part of it or just drove me and hung around because we were.
Your dad got you your own set of Merrells and you didn't even realize.
Probably at that point, we had a little vests that we had to wear, but like, all it was like, basically it's like survival skills. They teach us how to like tie knots and stuff, and there was like camping trips. And then from what I can remember too, this was also like 19 years ago.
Yeah, fair enough.
And then I think like there was not even me because I was too young, but like at one point my brother was in like a build your own like race, like a box car. It was like a box car race that they organized. It was like at the mall and they had this they set up a little like track.
Right.
And you had to like set up your own car. They set up little ramps and hills and shit. And like, you just have to build it from scratch and go. I don't know. Just
seems
little
like
activities.
A pretty good time.
I think it's just like to keep you out of trouble, like learn the outdoors, make sure you're like not fully like incompetent if you had to spend the rest of your life out there.
Fair enough. I'm going to mine simple, just stuck outdoors. I just love being outside. I think I could make it work no matter what the conditions are. And that being said, if I had to be stuck outdoors, I'd probably just go somewhere where it's hot all the time. Because I think it would be more manageable to be outside while it's hot all the time than where it gets cold. Or that being said, I would go to somewhere where it's like much more neutral, where like the heat is the same as it is here.
Yeah.
But like the cold is
It's not
like
as
not
bad.
as cold. It's like fall when it's cold. And I think that like even if it snows, like you just manage it, but it doesn't snow like here, that would be the perfect way to do it. So I'd go stuck outdoors.
And the craziest thing is, we didn't even mention that if we were stuck indoors for the rest of our lives, we couldn't see anybody ever again.
Right.
Like in
True.
person, like all of your friends would just be like, what the hell's, what happened to this guy?
Yeah.
And you'd
He's gone. He's a
FaceTime, like,
hermit.
hey, I'm alive still. But like, so yeah, you want to come out? No, like,
No,
bye.
I can't.
Every time. That's a quick way to lose your entire friend group.
Yes.
No. No, man. No, man. No, man.
And last this or that here, have no sense of consequences or see all consequences of every action. So, like before you do something, every time before you're going to do it, you see every single consequence that could occur or will occur from you doing this, or you have no idea what the consequences could be. You just live willy-nilly.
Well, it's kind of how we live now. Like
To an
anything we do
extent.
could have, yeah, but anything we do, like me leaving the house at 10:15 to check out to my lawn could have consequences.
I
There could
think
be
more
a
so it
gunman
comes
outside
down
my
to
door.
like making decisions, like when you like not doing like an everyday thing. Like I think it's more of if I do this as opposed to that, or like if I decide to go out and drink tonight, it's not like the consequence of like, oh, I could get hit by a car consequence. It's
Okay.
like, what are the repercussions of me going and doing this? Like the consequence is that tomorrow I'm gonna wake up really late and I'm going to miss this meeting that I'm supposed to have, and I'm going to and et cetera.
Yeah.
And not like, oh, I'm gonna go outside and like the worst case scenario is gonna happen. I don't think it's like that kind of thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's a little more broad. I think that makes my decision easier. I'm gonna see the consequences of every action. I
Okay.
think it can make me quickly. And the thing I was concerned about, which was just part of the reason why I asked you, is like if there were like infinite outcomes of like anything you did, and you could see every consequence of every action, because it says see all consequences of every action, that would be an incredibly stressful thing. Like your mind would just be like racing a million miles a minute. You'd be an anxious, nervous wreck.
See, that's kind of what I was thinking it was going to be like. So I was going to stay away from that because I don't want to have that.
Yeah, because it says all consequences of every action, which is like
Yes.
that would turn you into someone who's stuck indoors for the rest of your life.
Right, exactly. That was kind of where I was leading more to the path of have no sense of consequence, because like then you can just go and do, as opposed like if the other option is to be like super paranoia, like I would much
Yeah.
rather just have not see
No
any
sense of, and
consequences.
that being said though, this isn't saying that like our moral compass isn't there. It's not like, oh, I can't see any consequence, I'm gonna murder somebody. Like it's not nothing like that.
No, I don't think it's like that far. It's not that to that extent. It's
Yeah.
just like if we're gonna
You're
live
not
our lives, this
clueless.
no,
You're
you know,
just
you understand. It's more of just like your everyday decision of like things you do and how it impacts your life.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with no sense of consequence then. Keep things interesting. Because if you knew what was gonna happen, or the any like a potential, or like you could see everything that was gonna happen, nothing would come as a surprise to you.
Yeah, but it would also just be like very stressful
Overwhelming,
too.
yeah.
Yeah, and overwhelming. Yeah. So yeah, same page. I think it would be nice if things were surprising a little bit. If you
Yeah.
live with no con seeing no consequence, you
It could be
just
dangerous
do,
though.
man.
You just do.
Yeah.
You do.
All right, McGee. Well, I think that pretty much does it for episode 91. That was a good player battle, little judo battle. We got into a whole bunch of stuff before we even got into the player battle, breaking
Yeah.
down like
Months of the
what our
year.
worst month of the year is, and like comparisons of ages and times and all that stuff. I think this was a really good app. You kind of tease some things that are underway. One of them will come simultaneously with another thing that is in the works right now. It's not even just like, oh, something what's being talked about. It's like something that's actually happened. Like it's going down right now. We're just kind of waiting for some results to come in. Then you guys will see that. But make sure you go and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like, comment, subscribe, share that stuff. Go on to our Apple Podcasts, Spotify, We are currently, or I am currently working on switching us over to a new podcasting platform. It's called Anchor. So if you listen on Anchor, this also gets us onto a bunch of new podcasting platforms. So if you know anybody out there who doesn't have Apple Podcasts or Spotify and they listen on Google Podcasts or the Android apps or whatever their podcast platforms are, I know Breaker, or there was another one, like it was a radio one. If they listen on those, let those people know that we are now on there, because we are now available on all different podcasting platforms. This gives us much more access than we had before. So tell your friends to get out there and get on it. Make sure they listen, subscribe on their platforms, whatever they got to do. But honestly, Magee, that pretty much is all I got to say. We appreciate everyone's support. Appreciate everyone following along. This has been an absolute blast. We're winding down to episode 100 here. I'm really excited about it, but yeah, that's all I got to say, man.
Yeah, it's been exciting and big things in the works. Things are happening. Things have happened, as you said, that we're just kind of waiting for the final go ahead to announce. We are going to switch kind of our home base from the confusing link tree to one convenient location.
Yeah,
but that's kind of in the works. And I just want to, before we go, I just want to shout out Columbus, Ohio. Huge shout out to Columbus, Ohio. Over the last year, Columbus is our most viewed city, our most listened to city.
Nice. Shout out Columbus.
Yeah, we love you, Columbus.
I wonder what's going down in Columbus.
I don't know, but I don't care what anyone says. Ohio's not the most boring state.
Yes, exactly.
They got Columbus.
Shout out Columbus.
Yeah, and it's not even by a sliver either. Like, it's Columbus is like well ahead. it's pretty nice. So keep doing you, Columbus. That being said, catch us next week. Same time, same place, same lawn chairs. Cheers, lads and ladettes.
Cheers.